91,000 fans. Expansion due to be completed at the end at the beginning of the 2010 season. Over 100,000 seats will be in Bryant-Denny Stadium. I can remember just a decade ago there wasn't even a section on the other side of this facility on the upper deck, and now they have just about completed the entire circle of stands. Let's go down and check in with Kara Capuano as the head coach of the Alabama Crimson Tide alongside.
Coach, 2-0, but there's always room for improvement. What was one key focus in practice this week that you want to see from the Crimson Tide today?
Well, I think we want to start fast and finish strong. I don't think we really played dominant football for 60 minutes in any game that we played. We played well at times, but not with consistency, so that's the goal today.
I know you like to talk to your injured players and get that last question from them. What's the probability we see Julio Jones?
Well, Julio's didn't practice a lot. I think he's healthy enough to play today. We'll only play him in emergency.
All right. Thanks, Coach. Thank Appreciate you. It. Guys, so you heard the prognosis on Julio, a big maybe.
All right. Thank you very much, Kara. At Bryant-Denny Stadium, it's our SEC Game of the Week. It's our Wrangler SEC Game of the Week right here on the SEC Network. Alabama ranked fourth in the country with a 14-game regular season regular season winning streak, which includes SEC games as well, taking on North Texas. And a pleasant good afternoon, everybody. Dave Neal alongside Andre Ware, and of course some sunny skies have come out. Andre, that's good news because it had poured like the dickens here for the last 24 hours. But Alabama not only going to have to worry about the weather, they're actually going to have to worry about an opponent, something they're not quite used to seeing in the Mean Green in terms of offense.
Well, it's a little bit different spread type offense, more heavy on the passing side of it, and then so they do some trickery in the running game as well. It's going to cause Alabama to go nickel coverage to start this, an extra defensive back in the game as opposed to a linebacker. So there is room for concern for Alabama defensively.
Well, Alabama certainly a team trying to keep the momentum going. SEC season starts next week as they take on Arkansas. They want to get all their fundamentals in check, and you heard Coach Saban say we got to get off to a good start. That's been a problem.
Yeah, it really has. I mean, they want to get themselves started right out of the gate. This is a team that wants to be very, very physical in the trenches at the line of scrimmage, but they want to get off to an extremely fast start on the offensive side of the ball. They're going to get the ball first here, Dave, and we will see just how fast this Alabama offense can get started.
Well, North Texas won the toss. They deferred. Alabama will get the football first in this game. Javier Arenas, one of the premier return men in the entire country, punt or kickoff return, explosive. Not a great top-end speed, good speed, but it's his quickness and elusiveness that makes him so dangerous. Little squib kick, trying to keep it away from Arenas. Fielded by Baron Huber, who will take it up over the 45 to the 46-yard line. So the Alabama offense will come onto the field first. This is a group that is averaging 37 points a game, 271 on the ground, 235 on the air, and there's the man that has been in the center of the spotlight, Greg McElroy.
Yeah, he's waited his turn, waited in high school behind Chase Daniel, and then saw John Parker Wilson graduate, and he waited behind him, and now it is his turn and his show to run.
The junior out of South Lake, Texas, South Lake Carroll High School. First play in the pocket, hit as he throws, balls in the air. It's incomplete. Actually, no whistle blew. No whistle. They said that is a loose football. The beanbag came out from our referee in the backfield, Hubert Owens, and it will be North Texas football. Pressure came from Siobhan Atkinson, who forced the turnover.
Yeah, and he has two sacks coming into this football game. He was Greg McElroy trying to wait on the route of Mike McCoy to develop deep down the field, and it allowed for North Texas to get to the quarterback. But I know they've got to take a look at this upstairs with the new tuck rule in college football. This looks like a pass to me, and I think this one will be overturned and come back, and Alabama will set up for second down and 10.
Andre, this is an indication of one of the new things that the referees are trying to incorporate, and that is to not have such a quick whistle
right
on potential turnover situations. And I think that's an indication of what we just saw.
Allow the play to play itself out and not blow the whistle so quickly. But I think this one, when you look at it, Greg McElroy trying to throw the football. He was getting ready to release it down the field. They'll have the football back on the side of Alabama. I would be totally surprised if they don't overturn this one.
Good pressure right out of the gate, though, from the defensive front of North Texas.
Well, it's a defense that can get there. They came into the game with 4 sacks on the season, ranked 38th in the entire country in defense. So they've done some pretty good things on that side of the ball.
The ruling on the field is confirmed. Was a fumble recovered by North Texas. First down.
I'm totally blown away with that one. We take another look at this, and it looks as though Greg McElroy's arm is up in a throwing position and starting to come forward, and the ball comes out. Oh no.
Well, Boyle Jackson, our replay official, former referee here in the league out on the field, thought otherwise. So North Texas with the first turnover will have great field position on their first possession under center at quarterback Nathan Toon. He'll go up top. Incomplete pass, 2nd and 10 coming up. Nathan Toon, the junior out of Salina, Texas, is getting the start today because the normal starter, Riley Dodge, the coach's son, is out with a separated shoulder suffered last week in an overtime loss to Ohio. But Nathan Toon making his first career start today here on the road at Bryant-Denny Stadium.
Yeah, he's not as athletic as Riley Dodge. He's more of a pocket passer. So he'll be a stationary target for this Alabama defense.
Batted over the middle, incomplete. Looking for Michael Outlaw. And Riley Dodge is a guy that gives him a much different look offensively when he's on the field. Can actually run the football a lot more than Nathan Toon. So not having him in here, how does that change their offense?
Well, you know, you become more of a move the pocket type offensive team to more of a stationary quarterback there for the pass rush. Riley's a versatile quarterback. He's out with that second grade separation in his non-throwing shoulder. So hopefully they'll get him back relatively soon.
On 3rd and 10. Little dump down over the middle to Cam Montgomery. His 5th catch of the year will be shy of the first down as North Texas enters Alabama territory, but they'll have to punt it away.
And they tried to dodge Javier Arenas on the opening kickoff. you elect to punt it. Maybe they try to punt this one out the back of the end zone and give Alabama the football on the 20-yard line.
Will Atterbury, the true freshman out of Lewisville, Texas, 9 punts on the year, 42.5 yard average. Standing back is Javier Arenas. Leading the conference in punt return average. We'll let this one go. What a punt!
Well, that had some spin, some backspin on it.
Checked it back to the 4 yard line. Great punt by the true freshman Atterbury. First down, Alabama.
Let's take a look at the impact players for Alabama. Greg McElroy, their quarterback, 16-0 as a starter in high school. He's off to a great start here at Alabama, 2-0 on the season, and 2 fabulous linebackers, Rolando McClain and Dante Hightower. I don't know if any team in the country can say they have 2 that are as talented as that duo.
Our Hampton Inn impact players at Hampton. We love having you here. Well, Greg McElroy is going to have to shake off the early fumble.
Yeah, you know, that will play in the head. Pressure will play in the head of a quarterback faster than any defensive look you could possibly give him.
Here's Ingram. Out to the 20, to the 25 as his helmet comes off. First down, Alabama to the 26-yard line. Mark Ingram, who suffered from the flu last week, is close to 100%, if not 100%.
Just right at the line of scrimmage, he picks up some great blocks of center. They're out kicking out on the corner on the edge player, and I'll tell you what, Alabama runs it as good as anybody. 10th in the country so far for this short season running the football.
Alabama starting lineup above our scoreboard on your screen. Here's Ingram, the team's leading pass catcher with his 8th grab of the season. Gets it close to the 40-yard line. DeWaylen Cook pushes him out of bounds, a sophomore of Dallas, Texas, but another Crimson Tide, big chunk of green grass.
Well, this is the start that Nick Saban wanted for Greg McElroy. Get him in rhythm early in this football game. A nice, easy little flare pass out to Mark Ingram just to get his confidence back.
Marquise Mays, Mike McCoy to the top. He'll play action to Ingram. To the far side, wide open is Mike McCoy. He picks up about eight before he is brought down the far side. Let's take a look at the Principal Financial Group edge to the game, Andre.
Well, for Alabama, it's the offense getting themselves off to a fast start. They've come on at the end of games, but they wanted to get this offense off to a fast start today. Kind of stepped on their own toes early with that fumble from Greg McElroy, but they look pretty good right now.
Trent Richardson in the game, his first handoff. The true freshman will pick up the first down. Look at our principal edge keys to the game for North Texas defensively today.
Well, it's like most things, it stopped the run. They're going to get a full dose of Mark Ingram and Trent Richardson, the talented freshman from Alabama, running behind a big offensive line who will have their hands full on that side of the football, trying to stop Alabama's running game.
Two good linebackers, though, for North Texas. Toby Wigway in the middle leads the team in tackles. Quick hitter to the outside. Trent Richardson makes a couple of guys miss, falls forward to the 45, picks up a bonus 10 yards to get him about a 3.5-4 yard gain. Ira Smith and Royce Hill finally bring him down.
Well, he's not built like a true freshman. 5'11", 220 pounds. He's a grown man already as a true freshman. Right here, watch him. Just shoves him off and getting positive yards. And that's the thing you have to admire about him, is he doesn't waste any movement getting north and south.
Richardson stays in the game, gets the handoff. Out to the 42-yard line. In Tuscaloosa, Alabama, Dave Neal, Andre Ware, Karen Capuano, glad you could be with us for SEC Game of the Week, presented by Wrangler on a muggy, humid afternoon here in Tuscaloosa.
Kind of knew that was coming, didn't you? Once the rains cleared, it was getting a little humid here in Tuscaloosa.
Rains of biblical proportions in the last 24 hours. 10:45 to go, opening quarter. Alabama on the move. This drive started at their 4. Here's McCoy to the 33-yard line. First down, Alabama. Royce Hill on coverage for Damien Green.
Boy, Mike McCoy has really, really stepped up. Nice little speed out to the right side of the formation, away from Tripp's left. And it was just Mike McCoy to that side. And if you throw that a little bit late, it gives a corner time to break on the football. But you got to admire the timing of Greg McElroy on that play.
Out of the shotgun. In motion goes Brad Smelly, the H-back. Here's Ingram. He's tracked down for a loss of 3. Toby Nwigwe with the tackle. Let's go to our studios, our SEC Network studios, and Rob Stone. Rob?
We take you to Lexington. Louisville had just scored a touchdown. The ensuing kickoff, this was after a re-kick due to Louisville being offside, and Derek Locke gone from 100 yards out. Kentucky retakes the lead 10-7 in the first quarter.
Well, Kentucky's been impressive early this season. Got some offensive weapons again for Rich Brooks. Here's McElroy on second down. It's Earl Alexander, the junior out of Phenix City, Alabama, with his third reception.
We're talking about Kentucky. Their defense under Steve Brown's playing well as well. Playing Louisville today, already off to a 1-0 start. Defeated Miami University in Ohio in the opening week, but they didn't allow a point in that first week. So Kentucky and Rich Brooks getting it done early.
Randall Cobb, a quarterback last year due to some offensive situations, back out at wide receiver, leading the conference in receptions. Here's McElroy. Pass caught by Mike McCoy. Makes a man miss to the 10, to the 5, and run out of bounds at the 4-yard line by DeWaylen Cook. It'll be first and goal, Crimson Tide.
Boy, and he has really stepped up the last couple of weeks. It's going to be just a little drag route underneath, from Mike McCoy. You see him here. You get man-to-man, you keep running. If it's zone, you sit it down. You see the man coverage. But how about that? Breaking a tackle, you're picking up a nice block from Earl Alexander, the wide receiver on the other side. And Bama set up first and goal to goal inside the five-yard line.
McElroy, 7 out of 7. Handoff, Ingram. Hit at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard. Draylen Ross, one of those defensive tackles, the junior out of Fort Worth, steps up to plug up the hole. But how about McElroy? He completed 14 in a row.
Yeah,
his
school
record last week, and now he's off to another good start. 7 out of 7.
Well, they're glad that he made his way to Tuscaloosa. Originally committed to Texas Tech out of high school, but just came here on a visit and said it felt like home.
The first incomplete pass could have been a touchdown. Preston Dial.
And he got a good pass rush there by Craig Robertson, the outside linebacker from North Texas. You see him here blitzing from his outside linebacker position, but that's one the big fella's got to bring in right there.
Dial, the junior out of Mobile, Alabama. Runs in that H-back position for Alabama. So now it's third down and goal. McElroy flush, scrambling to the end zone. Touchdown, Alabama. The first rushing touchdown for Greg McElroy this season gives Alabama the 6-0 lead.
Looks like it took Greg a little while to get there, but he finally decided to pull it down and commit to get into the end zone.
Lee Tiffin with the point after. It is up and it is good. So Alabama fumbled their first play of the game. They get the ball back and go 96 yards. Greg McElroy, 7 out of 8 on the drive, and then caps it off with a 2-yard touchdown run. Alabama out in front. The Bear. You can't come to Tuscaloosa and not know that the Bear was here. He is everywhere.
A lot of tradition around this university, driving in, and you're just kind of blown away by all of it.
It's amazing. Alabama with a great drive on, you could actually say, their opening possession.
Yeah.
They had a fumble on their first play of the game, got the ball back, and you saw the numbers on that drive. They called officially 95 yards in 13 plays. Lee Tiffin will kick it off. Ira Smith will take it at the goal line. Ira out over the 20 to the 23 yard line. Take a look at our impact players brought to you by Hampton Inn. At Hampton, we love having you here.
Yeah, quarterback Nathan Toon making his first start today. He'll be joined by Cam Montgomery. They'll need his expertise on the ground. He's put together two really good back-to-back games. And then Toby Nwigwe on the defensive side. He is the team's best defensive player.
North Texas came out and threw on their first three plays of the game. Couldn't pick up the first down. See what they do here. Backed up inside the 25. A 6'4", 205-pound junior will throw it. Pass is caught by Jamal Jackson.
And this is where defensively you have some problems, because North Texas wants to get speed and space. The receivers do an excellent job of recognizing zone and man coverages. Where there, they get a little bit of zone, you get receivers sitting down in the hole for the quarterback and facing up. And it's not something Alabama's used to facing.
See the North Texas lineups on the top of your screen. Toon's pass caught by Darius Carey, the true freshman out of New Orleans, and he almost got knocked back to New Orleans by the big man, Terrence Cody, 6'5". They're saying 355 right now.
Well, he can move. Quickness to go along with the size. He's had an excellent offseason. Well, Texas there just trying to set up a screen pass to maybe break one out. Big Terrence Cody there.
Alabama moving around. Rolando McClain checking off defensively. Nathan Toon will respond in his own checkoff. Third and 10. First run of the game goes to Cam Montgomery, and that'll bring up a fourth down situation. Eric Anders, outside linebacker, will get credit for the tackle.
Well, North Texas is a balanced football team. 205 yards rushing on the average for the year and 201 in the air. Kind of surprised to see them throwing the football as much as they have early and then going to the run on third and super long. But maybe they'll get that ironed out as we go. But they can run the football.
Will Atterbury will punt away again. Bobble the snap, nearly blocked, but gets away a booming kick that sends Arenas back to the 22, and he dropped it. Bounces off one man, still on his feet. Can anybody catch him? Finally, they bring him down at the 33-yard line. Lance Dunbar finally tracks him down. An 11-yard return, a 52-yard punt. Alabama's offense back on the field when we come back. Welcome back to the Wrangler SEC Game of the Week right here on the SEC Network. Alabama leading North Texas 7-0, 5:27 to go here in the opening quarter from Bryant-Denny Stadium. Alabama's offense back on the field. Mays in motion. They will fake it to Mays and give it to Ingram. Good idea as he takes it into North Texas territory, and another big pickup for the Tide. But they had quite a few of those pickups on the last drive.
Yeah, offensive coordinator Jim McElwain did a good job here. They're going to get it started with Mark Ingram, then throw him a nice little flare pass out in the flat, let him work there. Mike McCoy underneath. He gets it down close, and then Greg McElroy going to cap it off with a 2-yard touchdown run for the Tide. 13 plays, 95 yards, 5 minutes, 52 seconds.
Here's McElroy, now 8 out of 9 this afternoon. Marquise Mays with the reception. You like the balance there.
Yeah, I really do. 8 passes, 5 running plays, and then McElroy on the drive, 7 of 8 for 61 yards. And Preston Dial should have caught that football. You want the touchdown pass, not the touchdown run if you're a quarterback.
You'd know about that. So what you're saying, that's what you wanted.
People don't pay attention to those rushing touchdowns. Trust me.
4:35 to go in the opening quarter. Here's Ingram. Gets a wall of crimson jerseys. Bounces off one man, still on his feet. Dropped at the 30-yard line. A flag is down back at the 42. Ira Smith finally brings down Ingram. Gain of 14 if it holds up.
This one may come back for a holding penalty. Yep. That's what it's going to be against Alabama. So this one will back the Crimson Tide up. But you got to be impressed with Mark Ingram as well as Trent Richardson. Two guys that are low center of gravity when they run the football makes it tough.
Holding. Number 73 on the offense. That penalty is 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Replay second down.
Makes it tough to bring them down and defenders coming up, and they're both well built down in the lower body, big legs for that added power that you need to break tackles. Impressed with both those both running backs for Alabama.
So Richardson will check in. Ingram will head to the sideline, and Alabama will look at a second down and 11. Richardson to the 42-yard line. Let's go to our studios. Rob, what do you have?
Well, guys, how about some Jim Tressel play calling for you? The sweater vest under heat in Columbus this week. Number 11 Ohio State taking on Toledo in Columbus. Terrell Pryor, Dane Sanzenbacher, their second hookup of the afternoon. 14-0 Buckeyes late first quarter.
Interested to see how much Ohio State responds, how big they respond after the tough loss. Toledo by a couple of touchdowns. Here's McElroy. It's Colin Peake, the tight end. First down, Crimson Tide to the 35-yard line. The Waylon Cook brings him down.
First down.
Look at the Big Ten in the top 25 right now. Penn State hanging in there at number 6. Ohio State, not much of a fall after a well-played game against USC. Just came up a couple of minutes short.
Yeah, and Michigan making its way into the top 25 with the defeat of Notre Dame last week. But you know, I expected Ohio State to stay relatively close to where they were before that game against SC. It was a well-played football game.
The play fake now. McElroy going to the end zone. Mays, touchdown. His third touchdown strike of the year. Lee Tiffin back on to attempt the point after. It is up and good. 14-0 Alabama. 2:52 to go in the opening quarter, and Greg McElroy is about as accurate a passer as you'll find early this season in college football. Right on the money. 14-zip tie. Nick Saban wanted a quick start from his ball club. I think they responded. Another big drive for Alabama, 67 yards. Marquise Mays with the 34-yard touchdown grab, just over 2.5 minutes. Darius Carey, a yard deep in the end zone, will bring it out. Slammed to the ground at the 14-yard line by Rod Woodson, the true freshman defensive back. Let's go back to that touchdown.
Yeah, let's take a look. Everything starts up front. They get tremendous protection up front, but you got two post routes, one on the outside and one here at man-to-man coverage. Watch Marquise Mays eat up the cushion of the safety to that side. No one over to that side of the field to help him out, and a well-thrown football from Greg McElroy.
Andre, he is 10 out of 11, 108 yards with a touchdown. And he also has rushed for one. Pretty good day.
He's on, big fellas.
Nathan Toon and North Texas trying to pick up a first down. Their third possession. Handoff goes to Dunbar. Back to the line of scrimmage. Let's go downstairs for more on Greg McElroy. Here's Kara Capuano.
Well, guys, Coach McElwain says that McElroy has that winning attitude. It's an intangible that cannot be coached. He also really gets it. As a quarterback, his role is to get to the open player. You mentioned the 14 in a row last week. He said after the game, what kind of a quarterback would I be if I couldn't hit 14 guys who were wide open? And, of course, he credits his teammates. And, Dave, what I remember was what Coach Saban said. He's not only the guy you want as a quarterback, he's the guy you want as your kid.
That handoff to Dunbar. It's maybe two on the play, but you know, just to kind of follow that up about Greg McElroy, you know, he learned a lot of that winning attitude from his high school coach, who happens to be roaming the sidelines for North Texas right now as their head coach, Todd Dodd.
Well, he knows a little bit about playing quarterback. He played quarterback at the University of Texas, so it's easy for him to teach it and pass that knowledge on. But you're right, Greg McElroy shows great poise. He doesn't panic when things are flying around him. He's that calming presence that you need in the huddle.
Four receivers set on a third down and 8 situation for the Mean Green. Pass is caught. Great catch at the 34-yard line by Darius Carey. That true freshman out of New Orleans that the coaching staff was telling us this kid has a chance to be really special.
Yeah, he goes on a little corner route, and it's an easy read for the quarterback. They get man-to-man coverage, throw it on the outside, and let the receiver make a play. And they say he has really, really started to play well as a true freshman. He had 6 catches last week in the Ohio game.
His 8th catch of the season picks up North Texas first down. Lance Dunbar, not much room. Dante Hightower steps up, that sophomore linebacker, 6'4", 255 pounds. and is a specimen. I mean, this combination in the middle, we talked a little bit about it in our pregame show, but Hightower and McClain, Andre, are just special, special players.
Well, they allow Alabama defensively to do a lot of things. He was a freshman All-American last year. They'll line him up at defensive end and put his hand on the ground, let him rush the passer.
Second down and 10. Dunbar. It'll be hard to run against this group, this front four of Alabama.
You've got a couple of guys in the middle. Talking Terrence Cody, who was not in on that play, but all 6'5", 255 pounds of him. And then Josh Chapman is a sophomore from Hoover, Alabama, who would start for a lot of teams around the country.
Well, that'll do it for the first quarter here in Tuscaloosa. Nick Saban said over and over again this week how much his club needed to get off to a fast start. They've been finishing strong, but I think they took his message and ran with it. Greg McElroy and company have been impressive through 15 minutes. A campus landmark, Denny Chimes at the Quad in the middle of this beautiful campus in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. As we continue with our SEC Game of the Week, Dave Neal, Andre Ware, Kara Capuano. We begin second quarter play. Sometimes the best seat in the house isn't a seat. It's up on the walkway.
Standing room only with a great view. How about that?
As the sun has peeked out. You know, it's funny. You just got to think the Bear might have had something to do with the sun coming out at kickoff, don't you? Third down, two. Tries to set up a little screen to Lance Dunbar. Dunbar out over the 40 to the 42-yard line. That'll be about 2 yards shy of the first down marker. Mark Barron, the sophomore safety out of Mobile, brings him down.
Boy, the thing about Alabama defensively, that where they've really improved was getting some more speed on the field. And Eric Anders, the senior linebacker, watching him, he can really operate. A lot of guys bouncing around making plays for Alabama defensively. It looked like that screen had a chance to at least pick up a first down. Boy, did they rally to the football well.
Javier Arenas back to return the punt of Will Atterbury. 6 career punt returns for a touchdown for Arenas. That is tied for the SEC record. A high kick that will drop at the 22 and roll out of bounds. Well, a busy day around the Southeastern Conference this afternoon and this evening. And, of course, later on today, Tennessee and Florida, a game many people not only in this league but around the country are looking forward to. And how about Gene Chizik's Auburn Tigers, 2-0.
Yeah, off to a great start.
And then Georgia going to Arkansas. They responded after the defeat to Oklahoma State with a good win against South Carolina. That'll be on ESPN later tonight. The Auburn game will be on at on ESPN2.
Good football being played around the SEC.
Trent Richardson gets the handoff. Trent with a big hole. Trent to the 40. Stumbles to the 45 of North Texas. And nearly came close to going 83 yards. Instead, it'll be 38 on the ground. Royce Hill barely tripped him up.
Well, just right behind Mike Johnson, one of two returning offensive linemen for Alabama. The left tackle, James Carpenter, does a fabulous job as well, opening up a nice hole for Trent Richardson, the true freshman. Boy, is he impressive.
Richardson will stay in the game on first and 10. McElroy will throw. Pass caught. Darius Hanks to the 25-yard line.
They may get a few more yards. There's a flag down, and it's going to be a late hit on Greg McElroy.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Number 47 on the defense. That penalty is administered half the distance to the goal from the end of the run. First down.
Brandon Opunku whistled for the violation, and McElroy having to shake that one off.
Well, you'll see it here. He delivers the football just a little bit late. Opunku arriving in the lap of Greg McElroy, so some additional yardage there for Alabama, as if they needed it, Dave. Boy, Greg McElroy on the money in this football game.
Trent Richardson will stay in the game alongside McElroy as Alabama sets up shop. First and 10, just outside the 10. Toss sweep to Richardson. Stays on his feet to the 5. Down to the 3, maybe the 2-yard line. Draylen Ross finally drags him down, a 9-yard pickup for Richardson. From Bryant Denny Stadium, Dave Neal, Andre Ware, Garrett Capuano on the SEC Network for Game of the Week presented by Wrangler. Alabama has marched the football at will this afternoon. They're doing it again on this possession as they will give them a 10-yard pickup on that carry by Richardson, setting up a first and goal now.
Well, you got the big fella lined up in the backfield, big Terrence Cody right there.
Mount Cody trying to pave the way for Richardson.
The fans love it. He is a folk hero in this town.
Toby Nwigwe with the tackle for North Texas.
Hey, you'll see him here set up. The big fella kicking out on Darian Williams. How about that? All 5'10", 189 pounds, a sophomore safety. And you got to get out in there and try to root out a guy that's 6'5", 355 pounds.
Cody still in the game. Here's Richardson. Hit at the line of scrimmage. Touchdown, Alabama.
Touchdown, Alabama.
The third rushing touchdown of the season and young career of Trent Richardson out of Pensacola, Florida. So Lee Tiffin back on for the point after. Twenty-one to nothing. Alabama out in front.
Well, and you got big Terrence Cody leading the way, kicking out on Dwaylen Cook. Bama having their way here in the first half. 21-0.
Alabama in complete control. Trent Richardson, the true freshman, getting a lot of carries today and makes that last one pay off for 6 points. How about that drive? 83 yards. Didn't take very long. And Alabama's offense is racking up some yards. Tiffin's kickoff will be fielded by Ira Smith. Ira out over the 30. A flag is down, however. Smith still on his feet, dropped at the 30-yard line, but a flag way back inside the 20.
Yeah, it's going to be a block in the back by John Shorter, a defensive back early right there, right in the back. And this one's coming back. This is the best starting field position North Texas has seen.
Illegal block in the back. Number 26 on the receiving team. That penalty is half the distance from the spot of the foul. First down.
So instead of having it at the Alabama 30, they will march it all the way back inside the 20. Actually, they'll mark it back inside perhaps the 10-yard line.
When you're going to see it come right into your screen, right as he starts right there, just number 18 right in the back, John Shorter. And instead of having tremendous field position, it's going to come all the way back.
And they will set up at the 9-yard line. That's where they'll scrimmage from with 11:44 to go in the second quarter. Cam Montgomery back in the game alongside the quarterback Nathan Toon, making his first career start in place of the injured Riley Dodge, who has a separated shoulder suffered last week in the second half. Montgomery trying to get that left side. It won't happen. Kareem Jackson with the tackle. But it's been all Alabama. They've scored in a couple different ways today.
Yeah, Greg McElroy gets the scoring started with a 2-yard run. No one open. Hey, I'll just pull it out, take care of things myself. He comes back and goes up top on a nice deep post to Marquise Mays. And then you get the freshman finishing things off with Trent Richardson and big Terrence Cody leading the way.
So second down and nine. Nathan Toon hasn't had very good field position other than their opening drive. That handoff goes to Montgomery, the senior out of the Woodlands, Texas. Let's take a look at today's road to the Dr. Pepper SEC Championship. Today we look back at Alabama's history in the SEC Championship, and you see 16 championship game appearances. They've gone 2-4 in those games. But overall, they have won 12 conference titles, the most in the conference. And this is a club that has eyes on getting back to yet another appearance at the Georgia Dome in December.
Fabulous program. You come here, you hear so much about the tradition of Alabama, and it still blows your mind.
Toon drops it off to Cam Montgomery. Montgomery out to the 20-yard line. That will be very close to a first down. I think he may have gotten it. They will move the chains. Justin Woodall, the safety, comes up to put him on the ground. Look at Todd Dodds, the head coach, also calls the plays.
Well, nice job here of recognizing he's going to get a little pressure. You get the hot read, dump it off, and allow Cam Montgomery to make a play for you. Makes one guy miss to pick up the first down.
The first down of the game for North Texas. Actually make that the second first down. 9:57 to go before halftime. That handoff to Montgomery.
Guess who's standing him up?
It'd be 62 down there. It's hard to miss 6'2".
Oh, Derrick Cody. Of them. I mean, you gotta see it to believe it. At 6'5", 355 pounds, and he is as quick as a cat inside. You cannot move that human being right there.
The one thing Mount Cody wants to do is play more third down situations, and apparently he's chasing Coach Saban around. Everywhere Coach Saban goes, even on the team bus, sits next to him. At practice, he's in his ear saying, "Coach, I can be a third down pass rusher. Give me a chance." The coach says, "You got to lose 5 or 6 more pounds before I let you do that, big fella." It's second down and 10. It's a pass rush situation for Cody and company. A little quick hitter inside slant out to the 29-yard line to Darius Carey.
It's going to be close, Dave, to a first down here. True freshman stepping up again. The officials do indeed mark it as a first down. Darius Carey, the thing you have to be impressed with about him, he was a high school quarterback who's made the transition to wide receiver for head coach Todd Dodge, but 7 receptions, 53 yards coming into this football game, and already 2 catches and a big one there to pick up a first down.
8.5 to go. That handoff into the middle of that Crimson Tide D line. Kareem Jackson comes up from his corner spot to crash in on the play. Well, Alabama basketball fans, get to Orlando, Florida, November 26th through the 29th to watch your Crimson Tide compete in the Old Spice Classic at the Disney Wide World of Sports Complex. For tickets and travel, visit oldspiceclassic.com. Second and 9. Riley Dodge in the middle, number 11, the starting quarterback, sending in some of those offensive plays. Toon hit as he throws. Knocked away at the last moment by Mark Barron. What a heck of an athletic play by the safety.
Boy, coming over the top to just make a nice play. Mark Barron, all 6'2", 214 pounds, and you see Nathan Toon here, pass rush, they're getting to him, and he's not able to step into this throw, but look at that athletic play. So many people talk and make so much of a case, and rightfully so, about McLean and Hightower. But these two safeties, in Barron and Woodall, are very, very impressed with these two on the back end.
Third down and 9. 5 receiver set, and North Texas wants a timeout. with that timeout. That'll give us an opportunity to head back to our SEC Network studios. And Rob Stone, Rob, what do you have?
Guys, the Javid Best Show continues in Minnesota. Two rushing touchdowns in the first quarter, a 27-yarder in the second, 116 yards already, the lead at 14 for Cal.
Thank you very much, Rob. How about the Golden Bears at 2-0 right now?
Yeah.
And, I mean, they are scoring 55 points a game. And we just saw Javid Best. I mean, this guy
arguably the nation's best running back, and what I like to refer to as negative body clock. Last year they went east to Maryland and didn't wake up till late in the third quarter, but they don't seem to have a problem in Minnesota today.
They good enough to beat USC?
I think they are. I think that's going to be one heck of a ball game later on in the season, but SC is going to have their hands full with the Golden Bears.
North Texas and Nathan Toon, they have their hands full right now. Third and nine situations are not what you want on the road against an Alabama defense that's allowing about 184 yards of offense a game. That's second in the league, 10th in the country.
Well, they've got McLean lined up in the slot. Now he's blitzing.
And then he drops off in coverage and nearly picked off by Mark Barron, looking for Alex Lott. That'll bring up a fourth down. Here comes the North Texas punt team.
Yeah, Lott's their possession type wide receiver. And he himself had seven receptions against Ohio, but yeah, they're giving a lot of different looks to a guy, Nathan Toon, making his first start, showing man to man, backing out in the zone. And you try to time that up as a quarterback, and just seeing a bunch of crimson moving around is what Nathan Toon's seeing right now from Alabama.
Arenas back to return the Atterbury punt. Arenas will field it at the 20. Out over the 30 to the 33-yard line. Give him a 10-yard return on a 41-yard punt. That'll take us to break. With 7:21 to go before halftime, Alabama up by three touchdowns.
The special thing about football is that it's a sport where you can actually get all your aggression out. You can hit somebody and you won't get in trouble for it.
Play football because you can hit people, get really aggressive, and you can hit people legally.
You hit somebody in the hallways at school, you get in trouble. You're out there playing football, you hit somebody, you know, nobody gets in trouble. Somebody pats you on the butt, tells you good job.
Take somebody's head off. Truthfully, yeah, that's my thoughts, just taking somebody's head off and making them play.
Well, it is a contact sport. Some sounds from around the SEC. First and 10 Alabama. Here's Mark Ingram to the 40, out to the 42-yard line. That'll be close to the first down. 10-yard pickup. Well, Andre, I know that you had a decent career. It resulted in kind of a Heisman Trophy. I guess it's okay career. Why'd you play football?
You know what? I just loved it from the first day, the first moment I was introduced to the game, and you couldn't get enough of it in the sandlot. It was finally 11 years old when I started playing organized football, but just couldn't get enough of it. And it was another way of kind of keeping yourself out of trouble as well.
Here's McElroy trying to stay out of trouble. Makes a man miss. Falls down to 48. That will be a first down, but I know the real reason. All those guys talk about contact. It's because that's how you get to meet the ladies. Come on.
Is that what it is?
It's all about the ladies.
I remember starting out as a running back in Pop Warner and then wanting to play quarterback so bad. You know, I was loud talking in the locker room in seventh grade. You know, I could how well I could throw the football. And got Coach Holmes he overheard me, and next day at practice he had me down on the other end of the field throwing passes, and that was the start of my quarterbacking career.
McElroy gonna air it out, looking for Brad Smelly, the H-back. From one quarterback to another, assess Greg McElroy today.
Well, he's been fabulous and tremendously accurate, short, intermediate, and long. And that will keep a defense on its heels. But you know what? Spreading the football around. And receivers, running backs, they love that. A guy that will move the football around, and you get the best out of each and every receiver that way, because you always think you have a chance of getting the football. He has been excellent with the ball today.
Another than an early drop by Preston Dial, his guys have been able to catch the ball, and this guy's been able to run it. Mark Ingram inside the 35-yard line to the 34. He is just churning up chunks of yardage. 17 on that pickup.
Well, he was the SEC player of the week after the Virginia game, and he's become a more patient runner, allowing that offensive line, a remade offensive line for Nick Saban, to really open holes and patiently working his way through there. I'm afraid to ask what he's averaging per carry today.
71 yards on 6 carries. Here's Richardson. He's in the game. And he's picking up about 7 on the play. DeWaylon Cook, the free safety, with his 5th tackle of the day. Vallejos with a nice block.
Well, you know, what makes it tough on a defense is when you have not just one guy, but a second guy coming in. He's 100% Trent Richardson. And he looks a lot like the first guy that's causing you problems. So they've got a 1-2 punch. And Roy Upchurch, remember him? He's sitting out this football game for Alabama.
Receiver set out of the shotgun on 2nd down. A big hit at the line of scrimmage from Toby Nwigwe. Nwigwe had 111 tackles last year, which led the Sun Belt.
He was second team all Sun Belt last season. His brother Joel was a wide receiver for the Mean Green. Actually played at North Texas as well.
Coming off a career high 15 tackles last week in the overtime game against Ohio. Alabama looking at a 3rd down. They've been perfect on 3rd downs today. 4 out of 4. All day for McElroy. He hits Ingram to the 10. Touchdown, Alabama.
Boy, credit 2 factors on that play, Dave. 1, the offensive line for providing Greg McElroy the time to find Mark Ingram, and then McElroy himself sliding around in the pocket. Boy, what presence he has in the pocket.
One after is no good by Lee Tiffin. His first miss of the season. But Ingram has shown he can run with the football. Now he shows he can do something with it through the air. Alabama out in front, 27-0. Alabama fans happy with what they've seen to this point, 27 points on the board.
I can guarantee you one guy that's not happy right now. Nick Saban with that missed extra point. Yeah, he's kind of like Tiger Woods in a way where he wants the perfect football game. Tiger wants the perfect round. Nick Saban wants the perfect football game for his team.
May never get it, but he strives for it.
No doubt.
And Ira Smith will bring it out of the end zone. He was 8 yards deep. Got it to the 16-yard line. Let's go back to that touchdown, Andre, and all day for McElroy.
Well, an outstanding job of working in the pocket. Watch the offensive line and McElroy, the eyes down the field. But here's a lesson in mechanics right here. You see where that football is? It's high. You look at the toes down there. He's on his toes. And this is a lesson for young quarterbacks. You don't need to drill that football. Just throw a nice, catchable touch football and allow your playmakers to take off for you.
So North Texas will have it 1st down and 10. Mark it at the 17. A quick hitter to the outside to Lance Dunbar. Not much happening there. Next to Jamal Jackson with the catch. Let's go down sidelines, check in with Kara Capuano.
Well, Dave, Andre was talking about how Greg McElroy chose Alabama after a visit. He had originally committed to Texas Tech, and he said when he came to Tuscaloosa and felt the passion of the fans and understood the richness of the tradition of Crimson Tide football, he had to be a part of it. That was a big part of the community and the domination that they established at South Lake Carroll High School. Obviously, out here, guys, it's magnified a millionfold.
Thanks, Kara. Second down. Lance Dunbar, nothing on that play.
Yeah, and just to top off what Kara said, his high school, South Lake, they are very community driven. That entire community follows that high school program, and he said he got that same feeling when he came on his visit to Alabama. And Kara, I thought, actually topped that story off very, very well. This is a community that loves the Crimson Tide. I'm on a flight from Houston getting ready to come into Tuscaloosa. Half the plane's dressed in Alabama gear.
They're everywhere.
Everywhere. Can't get away from them.
2:24 to go before intermission. Batted in the air, incomplete. No flags. Fourth down coming up. Javier Arenas on the coverage, and that's something Kirby Smart told us about Javier Arenas.
Yeah.
Probably overlooked is his ability to play in that secondary because he's such a special return man.
When he's not in his normal spot because of the offense that North Texas runs, he's been down in the slot most of this game with Marquise Johnson starting out at the corner position. So he's been in covering slot receivers and things of that sort. But this is his specialty, Dave. Punt returns and kickoff returns.
Alabama's been more of a four-man front today because of this four-man look.
Yeah.
Because of this North Texas offense. They usually base out of that 3-4.
And with that, able to keep, you know, some of their talent still on the field with Dante Hightower being able to drop his
right
hand
snap.
Down.
Delay of game. Number 41 on the offense. A penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot. Replay fourth down.
Yeah, he gets to showcase Dante Hightower a little bit for guys at the next level. But, you know, he's that size. Both he and McLean are that size where they could go either way at the next level.
Yep, he never comes off the field. When they're in their base package, he's a stand-up outside linebacker. When they want to pass rush, they put his hand on the ground, let him get off.
Will Atterbury's punt. Fair catch called for by Arenas at the 46-yard line. So a 38-yard punt with good hang time for Atterbury. Hightower and McLean, those two guys during practice and games, you can't separate them. Welcome back to our Wrangler SEC Game of the Week, the celebration of college football right here in Tuscaloosa, the Crimson Tide. At Bryant-Denny Stadium, it's been their on-campus home since 1921. They have won 219 games, lost just 46. Star Jackson in at quarterback. He will throw. Pass is caught by Darius Hanks. So Star Jackson getting some work. Last week, Star was under the weather. Thomas Derrick came in, actually played in front of Star. But Star, the number two man in this rotation, the redshirt freshman out of Lake Worth, Florida.
Well, wouldn't I tell you, watching him in warmups, man, he looks the part. And you see him in practice moving around, 6'3", over 200 pounds from Lake Worth, Florida. He has improved tremendously at the quarterback position.
And off to Terry Grant, who's getting some work in at tailback. But McElroy probably done for the afternoon. And the numbers he put up were simply marvelous.
Well, it was a quick day for him. 12 of 14, 157 yards and two touchdowns. Don't forget the rushing, that rushing touchdown.
Right, you like to say nobody remembers those.
No, nobody remembers those.
That pass.
Not unless you have RB by your position, by your name.
Right. A.J. Pinson, backup middle linebacker, knocks it away, but McElroy just continues to impress. And, you know, the biggest one of the questions was how would the quarterback position play out this year for Alabama? McElroy didn't throw a lot of footballs with John Parker Wilson running the show, but in talking to Greg McElroy yesterday, he was just so calm and collected.
Very intelligent football player, knows this entire offense and has been around it for 2 years now.
Jackson hits Mays at the 35-yard line. That'll be a couple of yards shy of the first down. Coming up on the Cellular South halftime report, we'll check in on some of those highlights as the Battle of the Commonwealth continues. Louisville and Kentucky. Ohio State trying to rebound today. And we'll have some highlights from around the Atlantic Coast Conference as well. That's coming up from our SEC Network studios. Rob Stone, Matt Stinchcomb, Brad Smelly with the grab. First down Alabama. That'll stop the clock.
Boy, you got to take your hat off to Nick Saban. He put Star Jackson in a situation here. 2-minute offense, a young player, and really speeding up his development.
Another quick hitter to Marquise Mays, who was tackled at the 25-yard line. But Nick Saban says it all the time, Andre. Every situation is a learning experience. Mm-hmm.
Every time you hit the field, you learn from it. You don't make the same mistake tomorrow as you made today. And I tell you what, I got to take my hat off to him. Putting a youngster in, a redshirt freshman, in this situation in a 2-minute drill and basically forcing him to think and react in a game time situation. It's fabulous.
Well, all season long, Champion Apparel will be showcasing the tradition and history of the SEC. Today, let's take a look at Alabama's football history, and what a history it is. Sixth in the Football Bowl subdivision, Division One history, with 801 wins. Those 21 SEC titles, of course, tops in this conference. 31 first round draft picks, but no Heisman Trophy winners.
I was blown away by that. You know, with a storied program like Alabama, you think at least one. And telling the SID, the Sports Information Department, said, when they do, he'll be a folk hero around here. He will be governor of Alabama when it finally happens.
Second down and 7 coming up for the Tide. Terry Grant inside the 20. That'll be close to a first down. First down, Alabama. 44 seconds to go. Bad snap, or a quick snap, and Star Jackson was calling out some signals, some protection, and didn't see it coming.
I'm going to take a timeout. All that positive yardage, and now you're taking a huge step back.
Who's that on? Is that a quarterback or a center issue?
Well, the center has got to be looking for that leg when it comes up. That tells you when to snap the football. But they get in there sometimes and, you know, start getting a little antsy. It's taking a little bit too long for Star Jackson to identify things defensively. And he thinks right now it should be snapped. All of a sudden the ball comes flying by you.
Now, you were mentioning the Heisman Trophy winners, and none from Alabama. But there have been a share of them in the SEC. Started with Frank Sinkwich back in 1942, all the way up until 2007, and Tim Tebow. Pretty good list of players right there out of the Southeastern Conference. Will somebody from the league get it this year?
Bo Jackson, could he run or what?
Yeah, that was. I mean, Bo Jackson, Herschel Walker, that era in the 80s of running backs.
I tell people all the time.
George Rogers.
Had he not been injured, we might talk about him as being the greatest football player ever to play. Ever.
Here's Grant off the right side. He will get out of bounds to stop the clock with 29 seconds.
Terry Grant out of bounds to the 25.
Tim Tebow will have the stage to himself today against Tennessee. Chance to build his Heisman resume, if you will.
I kind of think that's going to be a better football game, especially in the first half. Closer than a lot of people think. We got a chance to see Tennessee 2 weeks ago, and if we see that Tennessee team that took care of the football and Jonathan Crompton's able to come out and play the way he played that afternoon, it'll be close for a while.
There's always a caveat, for a while.
For a while. Right? Yeah.
It's close. For a while. Here's Jackson. Pass is caught inside the 20 by Brad Smelly, the sophomore out of Tuscaloosa. Younger brother of former South Carolina quarterback Chris Smelly, who's transferred here to Alabama and will vie for the starting catching role with the Crimson Tide baseball team this season.
It's like Coach Saban's thinking about going for it here on fourth down. He's going to trot that field goal unit out. And a nice job by Star Jackson. And not his fault, the snap that goes over his head. Did a fine job of recovering the fumble, saving the possession, hits two nice passes to get him in back in field goal range.
Folks, next Saturday on the SEC Network, Game of the Week presented by Wrangler. It's a conference matchup you won't want to miss as LSU and its intense defensive unit head to Starkville to face a hungry Mississippi State team under first-year head coach Dan Mullen. The action begins at noon Eastern right here on the SEC Network. An SEC West showdown. LSU, a club certainly in the picture for an SEC West title. Had a good win over Vanderbilt in the rain. From 35 yards out, Lee Tiffin is on the mark. And that will do it for the first half. All Crimson Tide. 30-0.
Well, that's about as good a first half as we've seen this short football season. They had a hiccup or two, but what a well-played first half by the Crimson Tide.
Let's go down and check in with Kara.
Coach, first possession aside, was that the faster start that you wanted to see from Alabama this week?
I think that's the way we wanted our guys to play. I think we got to be responsible for what our, you know, sort of ability is. And I thought we played better today, what our potential is. And we got to finish the game. We wanted to start fast and finish strong, so we want to finish the game.
Greg McElroy, how would you characterize his first half?
Well, he's done a great job for us all year, and he did a nice job. I was proud of the way Star played. It's only the second time he's ever been in a game in a two-minute situation and handled it pretty nicely.
Coach, thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
Dave, as you mentioned, every opportunity is a learning situation for Coach Saban's kids, and Star did a good job.
Yes, he did. Alabama did a good job as a team, too. They lead it 30-0. Let's go to Rob Stone in the studio for the Cellular South Halftime Report. Welcome back to our Wrangler SEC Game of the Week from Bryant Denny Stadium here in Tuscaloosa, where it has been all Crimson Tide. Other than one minor hiccup, the first play of the game was a fumble by Alabama, but since then it has been all Crimson Tide. Dave Neal back alongside my partner Andre Ware. And Andre, we've talked about it, but it's really been the theme this week for Alabama, this quick start. And I think it all starts with the quarterback.
Well, it really did. And Greg McElroy had an outstanding first half. 12 of 14, 157 yards, two touchdowns, along with a rushing touchdown as well. That's about as clean as you can play a first half. As you mentioned, the hiccup, but once they got past that, it was all Alabama.
It was an awesome display, to say the least, really on both sides of the football. So Alabama will kick it off to start the second half. Lee Tiffin will send it into the end zone, and North Texas will bring it out to the 20-yard line. Let's take a look at our first half highlights brought to you by Nike Pro Combat.
Well, you see Greg McElroy here starting it off with a 2-yard touchdown run, and he goes back to the air. Finding Marquise Mays on a nice corner right. He dumps it off. Mark Ingram's going to do the rest of the work for the quarterback here. All Mark Ingram on that play, but fantastic first half for Alabama.
Nathan Lane, who got the start at quarterback today, Andre, for this North Texas club, 8 out of 13, 50 yards in the first half. Get your thoughts about him in a moment as we watch Cam Montgomery lose a couple of yards into that line of scrimmage. As we take a look at our first half stats brought to you by Crystal, nothing like it.
Well, look at the rushing yards for Alabama, 165 passing, balanced. They came into this game very, very balanced on offense, and it kind of remains true to form through the first half of this one.
So Lane, the junior out of Salina, Texas, still taking the snaps for North Texas. Little throw. Ball is dropped by Darius Carey and then picked up. They'll say it's incomplete.
What a sure-handed Darius Carey. He was the bright spot in the first half for North Texas.
Let's go downstairs, check in with Kara.
Well, guys, I had a chance to talk to Coach Todd Dodge walking out on offense. He said first downs beget first downs. They need to put themselves in position on first down to create more first downs. On defense, tackle, tackle, tackle. He says his defense is actually executing pretty well, but they're not getting their feet under them to wrap up their man. And you know what happens against Alabama if you don't wrap up the man, guys.
They will pick up 10, 15, 20 yards at a clip if you don't tackle.
Big plays.
Two. Pass complete out over the 20. Mark Barron in on the tackle. You see Nathan Toon picking up that helmet as the punt team comes back on.
He's been fairly accurate with the football, but Alabama's just kind of holding him to those short intermediate routes to get him to third down and long. I think for North Texas, if you're going to have a chance to get yourself back in this football game, that's the first order of business, is to stay out of third down and long against a good Alabama Alabama defense.
Atterbury to punt it away. Nice spiraling kick that Arenas would take at the 25. Wall set up. Arenas makes a couple of guys miss. Still on his feet. Still on his feet inside the 40. Jeremy Mathis finally brings them down. But Andre, you got Brandon James down in Florida. That's a return guy. You got Javier Arenas here at Alabama. I don't know that there's two guys in the country any better than those two. They're exciting.
Boy, watch this. And the wall sets itself up. But then a lot of this is just going to be Javier Arenas right here. Breaking tackles. Determination right there. Spinning, clawing, scratching. Well, that's entertaining. I bet he was some running back when he was in high school. Had to have been a running back.
You don't want to blink when Arenas is on the field. Greg McElroy will start the second half for the Crimson Tide. Trying to build on his already impressive numbers, and he'll do so as Colin Peake, the tight end, the senior at Ponte Vedra Beach, Florida, transferred in from Georgia Tech, makes his fifth grab of the season. At 25 grabs in 07, his final year at Georgia Tech on the Plains.
Yeah, he just didn't fit into that triple option attack of Paul Johnson, so he decided to get himself to Alabama and become and stay at the tight end position where they throw the football to the tight end a little bit.
Said the Plains, that's Auburn. Of course, the flats is Georgia Tech. I should know that. I live about 2 miles from the campus. It's not flat, I can tell you that. Hand off to Ingram. He's driving his feet down to the 5-yard line. Ira Smith hopped on his back for about a 5-yard ride. First and goal, Alabama.
Well, you know, Dave, talking to Coach Saban yesterday, coming into this season, there was a lot of concern about that Alabama offensive line, and two starters were back. Mike Johnson, the left guard, and the right tackle, Drew Davis. He said when he came in, James Carpenter playing next to Mike Johnson, that's helped. They put Barrett Jones next to Drew Davis. That's helped. Two experienced guys there and two newcomers. They've helped each other out. Alabama's offensive line, not much to worry about.
Touchdown, Alabama, Mark Ingram. How easy did that look? His second touchdown today.
And they go right behind Mike Johnson, who's playing the best up front on this offensive line. The left guard, nice little double team with he and James Carpenter, create a nice hole for Mark Ingram to sneak into the end zone.
Tiffin's point after is up and good. He missed his last point after attempt, so he's back on track. 37-0. Alabama's offense has been nothing short of awesome. You are looking at the Gorgas House, the first structure to be built on this campus, one of only four buildings on campus that survived the Civil War, built back in 1829. There's some impressive structures throughout this campus, this being perhaps the most daunting. Next year when they come on this field, 101,000 fans will be looking down. Three plays, 39 yards, all of 54 seconds. Mark Ingram with a 5-yard touchdown run. Tiffin's kick about 7 yards deep in the end zone, out to the 20-yard line. Well, we'd like to recognize Greg McElroy from Alabama as our SEC Network Scholar Athlete of the Game. ESPN Regional Television will contribute $1,000 to Alabama's General Scholarship Fund on their behalf. Congratulations to Greg, who graduated in 3 years with a business marketing degree. He is now working on his master's degree in sports marketing. Just shy of 3.9 GPA, right around Andre's level.
Yeah, all 4 years, 3 years combined.
Had enough. I hear you, man. I'm all about it. It's nice to be able to talk to smart people, though, isn't it?
Yeah, he was very, very impressive.
That handoff goes to Hamilton. Let's go ahead and check in with Kara.
Well, guys, you were talking about Greg McElroy's smarts, as I like to call them. His dad is a vice president of sales and marketing with the Dallas Cowboys, and he's, as Greg works on his master's in sports management, he too would like to work with a sports franchise one day. And Greg says it's his intelligence that makes him such a good quarterback. He knows where everybody is supposed to be on the field at any given time, and he can answer any question in the huddle.
Tunes pass is caught. The Crimson jersey swarming to the football to tackle Michael Outlaw. You know, in your offense, you ran the, I mean, it was one of the first wide open passing attacks that we can remember.
Yeah.
How long did it take you to grasp that at Houston?
Well, it took a little while into my freshman year, and then about the second game after going through two-a-day practices and things of that sort, the light kind of pops on. You have to be smart. You have to know where everyone is, both on offense and defense. Right here out of the SEC, one of the smartest guys playing football, Peyton Manning, knowing where everyone is, getting them in and out of plays.
Tune hands it off. Hamilton again. James picking up about 6 on the play, just shy of that first down. Robbie Green, backup safety, runs him out of bounds. The sophomore to New Orleans, Louisiana.
And there's that old monster kind of showing its head again. 3rd down and 7. You get 5 yards, you're a little bit short. You're still in pretty much, you know, bad field position, because, you know, I would say average field position to start this drive, but you can't convert. And now you're going to punt the football to an explosive returner.
Atterbury's punt will sail out of bounds. They will mark it at the 48.5-yard line. So the Alabama offense coming back on the field. Back in a moment. Back at Bryant-Denny Stadium, Dave Neal, Andre Ware, Alabama leading North Texas 37-0, 10:34 to go in the third quarter. Star Jackson back in at quarterback, the redshirt freshman out of Lake Worth, Florida. Came on in the first half, ran a little 2-minute offense, got the team in field goal position. Now back throwing again, and this pass incomplete, looking for Mike McCoy.
Boy, Dwaylon Cook got a nice jump on that pass.
Let's take a look at the upcoming schedule for Alabama, brought to you by Toyota, moving forward. And next week, it's serious. All the fun and games over for Alabama as they take on Arkansas right here at Bryant-Denny Stadium. That's a tough stretch right there. They do have that week off between Tennessee and LSU, but there's nothing easy about that.
They may have one of the toughest schedules once they get to conference play at Kentucky, at Ole Miss. Some tough football games coming up for the Crimson Tide.
Here's Trent Richardson. Richardson had a good first half, over 70 yards on the ground. He and Ingram have been a great 1-2 combo today, despite the fact Roy Upchurch is not playing today with a high ankle sprain. The combination of that and a soggy field just wasn't the right combination for Roy Upchurch, and you want to get ready. But what's your take on, you see like a guy like Richardson playing well, Upchurch is normally the number 2 guy. Does Upchurch come back in and get those number two carries next week?
Get well faster.
Yeah. Here's Jackson. Pass a little bit high off the fingers of Marquise Mays.
Been very, very impressed with Star Jackson. Only thing he's got to work on, a little bit of touch. That one had a little heat on it, sailed on him a little bit, but just take a little bit off of it. The receiver's coming to you and not away. So you want to throw something out in front and allow him to catch the football. But you look at it, we had a nice visit with Rolando McClain yesterday. He says, Coach, always testing you mentally. Do you think Star Jackson thought he was going to get in a football game today and run the 2-minute drill before the first half was over? My bet is no. And that tells you, you better be ready when you're called upon here at Alabama.
P.J. Fitzgerald punting away, wearing number 7 today and not his normal 97. Punts it through the back of the end zone. A 49-yard kick, of course, the net on that will be 29 yards. Time for us to head to our SEC Network studios and check in with Rob Stone. Rob, what do you have?
Well, Dave, Michigan coming off that big win versus Notre Dame, struggling with Eastern Michigan, but how about a little razzle-dazzle? The reverse to Martavius Odoms from 13 yards out. Finally, some breathing room, 31-17 for the Wolverines.
Boy, Andre, you just knew there would be somewhat of a letdown for the Wolverines after that thrilling win last week.
Yep. Anyone else other than maybe Eastern Michigan, and you have that type of letdown, you're playing from behind.
That handoff goes to Cam Montgomery. How about Boise State last night? It looked very impressive on the road against Fresno State, sitting there at the number 10 spot. Of course, BYU there at number 7. I mean, there's a couple of clubs that could really cause a problem.
Shake some things up.
Yes. It may not be.
Some things up.
Everybody wants it to be so simple and easy to figure out. But you get Boise State and BYU in the mix, and it becomes somewhat complicated.
I love it. Every year it gets even more complicated than the previous year.
That pass caught on the far side. Darius Carey. He is slammed backwards. They will spot his forward progress at the 24-yard line. But once again, a third down and relatively long. Third and about 6 coming up for the Mean Green.
Well, this at least you can somewhat convert. When you get 7-8, third and 7, 8, or 9, tough to convert third down. Call this one a long 5.
Arenas comes up to the line on the left side. A little slip screen. Jamal Jackson going backwards, and he's dropped back at the 12-yard line. Mark Barron with a great play from his safety spot.
What teaching point there on a screen pass that is designed to catch and get up the field. A fast defense. You're not going to outrun 10, 11 other jerseys trying to break it all the way back across the field. Get the ball, get up the field north and south.
Atterbury to punt it away to Javier Arenas. He'll have plenty of room for the return. He's got some blockers. Knocked out of bounds at the 35-yard line. A 33-yard return by Javier Arenas.
And I'll just take a seat.
He's a special, special player. Back in a moment.
SEC football is the best. You have competition day in and day out.
You got guys that can run at every position.
Fierce. It's a lot of competition.
We're known for having some of the best teams in the country.
Every team is going to come to play every week, so you can't take a day off. You're going to be able, you're going to have to compete against every guy in the SEC.
You get beat up playing SEC football.
Nothing like it. SEC football.
It's great.
Jackson in at quarterback, hands it off to Terry Grant. Terry to the 25-yard line. Let's take a look at our game summary brought to you by Woodman of the World Life Insurance Society of Omaha, Nebraska. And basically the summary is Alabama got off to a fast start, put the pedal to the metal, and they haven't really let up yet.
No, McElroy came out, kind of picked up where he left off. Mark Ingram as well has had a fantastic football game so far. Both those two deserve the rest of the afternoon.
Here's Jackson's handoff. Grant inside the 20. That'll be a first down at the 19-yard line. Let's go downstairs, check in with Kara Capuano. Kara.
Well, guys, we've talked about Coach Saban wanting his squad to start fast. And to address that, he talked about aspiration versus inspiration. Inspiration demands something to happen externally, such as the slow start against Virginia Tech and their appropriate response. With an aspiration to be great, you can set the tone from the start. And that's the illustration, the message he was trying to send. It seems like they got it today.
I'm glad Kara handled that story, not us.
We'd have messed that one up big time.
Here's Grant. He's not messing this up. First down, Alabama. It'll be first and goal as he takes it down to the 7-yard line.
No, but you know, he's always testing his players mentally. And he's big on not making the same mistake twice and kind of putting everything secondary for the betterment of the team. And I'll tell you what, he's fabulous to be around. You know, always wanting the best from his players, and he gets them to commit to it. And you talk to any player on this roster, he is they respect the heck out of Coach Saban.
Here's Grant working that right side down to the 5-yard line. You know, we see him in a little different environment than what many people see on television. Right. We get to have these, you know, meetings with him 30, 45 minutes before a game, and you get to talk about other things sometimes besides football. But, mm-hmm. You know, he is more than this tunnel vision guy that people have an impression of. He really cares about, as you said, each one of these kids. And I think you listen to the players talk about him and how much they respect him. And Rolando McClain was saying how he was so, when Coach Saban first got on campus.
Scared of death, every one of them.
And now they just can't get enough of Coach Saban. Way down to the 1-yard line.
Grant's been impressive coming into this game. He led the team in rushing 2 years ago, 891 yards on the ground. He's a versatile player that they like to, with the first group, they'll line him up in the slot at receiver and get him the football out in space and let him do his thing. But he's having a little fun right now lining up at running back, at tailback.
Is to cap it off here. And he does. Touchdown, Terry Grant in Alabama.
Nice drive, and you got to credit the offensive line because he did most of that on the ground behind that big offensive line, moving bodies. And if you thought or were concerned about Alabama's offensive line, no need to be.
Going after is up and good. James Carpenter, Mike Johnson, William Vallejos, Barrett Jones, Drew Davis. Those guys have been doing the job today. So Alabama out in front, 44-0, 4:29 to go here in the third quarter. We've got a moment, so let's send it to our SEC Network studios. Rob Stone.
Dave, we've been praising Javid Best of California all day, but how about Minnesota's Eric Decker? Two TD receptions, and now he takes the pitch and throws for one to back up QB Marquise Gray. Hey, we're tied up at 21s.
Eric Decker, my friend, is a player. And a lot of people thought I was crazy when I said Minnesota got him finishing right around second in the Big Ten this year. They ran off. They were 7-1. We went in there and did a game. They didn't win another game the rest of the year, but they had everybody, it seemed like, coming back to that football team. And they were going to have something special this season. We're off to a good start.
Boy. You know, you talk about coming back. Last year, Alabama played 16 true freshmen. Nick Saban threw them to the Wolves, and I think you're seeing a lot of that playoff this year in terms of some depth for Alabama across the board. Terry Grant, a guy that, you know, was their leading rusher a couple of years ago, he's dropped all the way down to 14 tailback. Ira Smith has a chance for the return here. Dropped at the 21-yard line. Well, we touched on a little bit, but as far as college football headlines. Michigan back in the top 25 with that big win over Notre Dame, 38-34. How about those BCS busters at BYU, TCU, Boise State, Utah? BYU, of course, taking on Florida State tonight at Texas Tech, and Texas tonight, a rematch of that thrilling game from a year ago. Texas Tech won that one.
You know, we forgot my Cougs, man. University of Houston upsetting the number 5 ranked team in the country, Oklahoma State, on the road. I'll leave my Cougs out of that.
Tate Forcier from Michigan with that big touchdown run, forced out of the game today by the Wolverines with an injury. That pass is incomplete. By the way, listening to you hoot and holler while you were on your phone trying to get the game by game play on your phone on the way from Gainesville to Jacksonville last week was quite comical.
I could not have been a prouder alum last week, and you knew Oklahoma State was going to make a run out of halftime, but you know they were able to overcome that and fight back and score and ultimately win the football game. Big for the program there.
A lot of people talking about a chance for Houston to run a table now.
Might happen. We've got a stretch of games though that are going to be a little tough.
Nathan Toon with a carry out to the 28-yard line. Dave Neal, Andre Ware, Kara Capuano on the SEC Network Game of the Week presented by Wrangler from Tuscaloosa. Where the rain has subsided. It was pouring right up until kickoff, and then wouldn't you know it, disappears. It has been all Alabama in this one. They fumbled on their first play from scrimmage. Gave the ball to North Texas. Great field position. 3 and out for the Mean Green. And then since that point, Alabama has been on cruise control. Tune flushed out of the pocket. Lofts it up in the air. Nice throw and catch. Michael Outlaw inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Great combination, quarterback receiver. Boy, they were on the same page.
Well, excellent job in the scramble drill. Your quarterback gets in trouble. Now you got to find an area of the field in which to get open. And for Michael Outlaw, it was just turn up the sideline and look at where this football's thrown. Running a guy in your face, and it's about as well thrown as we've seen all afternoon. Excellent play. Excellent throw and catch.
Outlaw dropped a couple of potential game winners last week in that overtime loss to Ohio. And Nathan Toon will call a timeout. If you're just joining us, Greg McElroy having another outstanding afternoon for the Crimson Tide. It's one of those days where you sit back, maybe have a little sip of tea. Not for Greg McElroy here in the first part of this game, because Andre, he was as accurate as you will find, but gets one on the ground first.
He started it with his legs, and then he goes up top and finds Marquise Mays for the touchdown. Then got Mark Ingram involved in it. Nice little dump off pass. Ingram's able to take that one to the end zone, but he's had a fantastic afternoon. He is the guy. We talked to the coaching staff. He says this team responds well to Greg McElroy, and he knows what he's doing and what everyone else is doing. Came out and showed it in this game today.
And because of that, he'll be our Wrangler 5-star player of the game. 13 out of 15, 176 yards, 2 touchdowns through the air, 1 on the ground, and he actually had 1 drop ball. Could have been a potential touchdown on that opening drive.
Could have been the third touchdown pass, or the first of 3. If Preston Dow is able to hold on to that baby.
A little quick hitter. Pass caught by Jamal Jackson. He's to the 35-yard line. That'll bring up a 2nd down and 6. Chris Jordan, sophomore out of Brentwood, Tennessee.
Well, this is the best drive that Mean Green has put together today.
And you know, this is not the offense that North Texas runs with Riley Dodge in there.
A little bit different.
You know, you run a little more counter production plays, a little more quarterback keepers.
And you're going to move the quarterback a little bit, not as stationary as when Nathan Toon's in the game.
Pass is caught by Lance Dunbar. He will take it to the end zone. Touchdown, Mean Green. 35 yards on the pitch and catch.
Kind of looked like
a mix up in the secondary. The outside linebacker Corey Reamer, responsible for the back, Lance Dunbar on the outside. I was more impressed with the catch back on the hip, reaching back to grab it and still maintaining his stride.
Jeremy Knott, senior out of Tulsa, Oklahoma, in to attempt the point after. And that is good. 2:11 to go here in the third quarter. Alabama leads North Texas 44-7.
Five plays, a 34-yard touchdown pass from
How about the catch from Dunbar out of the backfield? That was a pretty athletic move.
Well, excellent play. You're going to get the receiver here come down inside in a nice pick. And then you get Dunbar down the sideline. It's an excellently designed play. Nathan Toon right there on time. He trapped Corey Reamer inside, who's responsible for the back to that side. And then Lance Dunbar off to the races. Right here, nice throw. That's a little bit behind him. Nice catch, but able to kind of maintain his stride. Green getting themselves into the end zone and on the scoreboard.
Dunbar, the sophomore from Alton City, Texas.
Coach Todd Dodge kind of described him as having home run hitting potential.
Missed two games. Missed actually the second half of last year with an injury. Played about five games. They're glad to have him healthy this year. Give them a chance in the Sun Belt. Trying to move up that pecking order. So Knott will kick it off. Arenas and Grant back to return the kick for Alabama. It will be Javier Arenas. Javier making a couple of guys miss again. Javier Arenas to the 40.
He is something else.
61 yards on that return. And let's send it to our SEC Network studios and Rob Stone. Rob.
Dave, Kentucky imploding in the second half. Three second half turnovers, the latest, led to this Justin Burke to Cameron Graham touchdown. Louisville now with their second lead of the game, 20-17 in the fourth.
Wow. Still plenty of time for the Wildcats. Hold on to the football, though. Star Jackson will hand it off here. Off the left side goes Trent Richardson. Inside the 30, down to the 27-yard line. Arian Williams brings him down from the safety position. You know, there are so many numbers. You look at Javier Arenas. They can make a difference, yeah. But he is such a difference maker. It is like an extra offensive possession when he has the football.
When you get and you or you have a return man that is dynamic as he is, you're going to have excellent field position to start a lot of drives, and that in itself could make the difference in a football game in a lot of situations.
Low snap. Terry Grant will fall on it. Second time we've had a little mishap. Center to quarterback, but you know, that's an area Nick Saban, this Alabama team, if you had to pick one area that's been really disappointing for him, was their kick coverage unit. Couple of touchdowns allowed. You know, you can't, when you get in the SEC play, you can't allow teams like Arkansas to work with short fields, and that's been a concern for him. And he knows that this is their last chance to really kind of button down those areas.
Well, all the things that have happened positively in this football game, he'll talk about those. The sack and the fumble early to start the game.
Here's Grant. Hauled down at the 22-yard line by Craig Robertson.
And he'll talk about the couple of fumbles, the center snaps over the quarterback's head. And those are the things he'll point to, because you're right. Those will get you beat once you get yourself into SEC type player. When you start playing teams from the SEC, that will get you beat. But you look at it as a whole, this program in good shape, Dave.
Yes.
You mentioned it. A lot of freshmen played last year. All that's been made about the offensive line, one senior, Mike Johnson, at left guard. Everybody else underclassmen. Mark Ingram, a sophomore. You got a redshirt freshman under center now. You get Greg McElroy back next year.
Earl Alex Xander on that reception.
Looks like it's 88 Michael Bowman who stepped in. Bouncing around. They've got some talent.
We're getting deep on the flip card now, Dre. Back in a moment. The Bear Bryant Museum across the street from the athletic facility and the baseball stadium. It is, if you're a college football fan and you're in the area, you have got to swing by the Paul Bear Bryant Museum.
That's sweet.
There's some great stuff in there. I've been in there about six times, and every time I find something else interesting in there. Out of the I formation, here's Terry Grant. For the 10, still on his feet, down to about the 7-yard line. Brought down by Craig Robertson with his sixth tackle of the afternoon. Let's check in with Kara.
Well, guys, Coach Bryant was a man of many sayings, and one of his favorites was, the little things will win for you. If you don't do them, they'll beat you big. Things like sprinting to the line of scrimmage to scare the opposition, just calmly handing the ball to the official after you've scored, act as if you've been there before. Andre, how much does Coach Saban remind the Alabama faithful of Coach Bryant?
Well, I think a lot. I mean, he has that demeanor, that tough demeanor. And as you mentioned, Dave, we get a chance to see him in a little bit different light. But, you know, outside of that, we think he's kind of got that same swagger, so to speak. And like he's never really happy with or satisfied with what's going on. Tough. And his football teams play that way. They are tough teams.
I think that's, you know, kind of what, talking to Jim McElwain, we're talking about, you know, what do you want your team, the identity.
Yeah.
You know, I want people to not want to play us. I want them to walk away from here going, boy, I don't want to play that powerful team. Here's Terry Grant. Tripped up at the 5. Nice tackle in the secondary. Darian Williams with a nice play. Sophomore out of Vernon, Texas.
This is their goal, is to be physical offensively, and the philosophy to find out what the strengths are from the good players and build on that, and don't expose what you would perceive as the weaker players. So they want to get the hands in get the ball in the hands of their scorers. Did a pretty good job of that this afternoon.
Star Jackson has played for the most part here in the second half. One series by Greg McElroy, and he's turned it over to Star Jackson. A flag down. Looks like delay a game coming up for the Crimson Tide.
Before the snap, delay of game. Offense, number 2, 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
You know, the other thing is, you look at Nick Saban, that he said that it's quite interesting, and I've been around him for a long time at his LSU days, right, and here, is that he treats this as like almost a pro concept. He wants to identify his top 47, 48 guys, you know, after in 2-a-days, and yeah, let those guys, now you're going to run with those guys. Those are your guys.
First 2 weeks of 2-a-days, right, you identify the players, and these are the guys that are going to play, and everybody else, hey, you'll service these guys.
Here's Grant. Gets it back inside the 5, down to the 4-yard line. You know, look at 29 right there, and Terry Grant. I think as this season unfolds, we will see a lot more of him on the football field, other than this kind of a blowout situation running back. They want to use him more in a slot type situation. Yep. He's too valuable to not be on the field with his outstanding speed.
A player that they can depend on, and has done a tremendous job in this program.
Gets another handoff. And I think that is probably what we're seeing right now. The one reason that Grant doesn't carry the ball more is between the tackles. He's not as physical as your Mark Ingrams and your Trent Richardsons and even your Upchurch.
You know, he said that, and I don't know if I necessarily agreed with that, because what's been kind of the norm around college football, smaller running backs and big offensive linemen. Look what they do down at Florida. Those guys aren't big.
Right.
They hide behind the big guys in front of them, and then all of a sudden the speed, you look up, they're on the second, third level of the defense.
Jackson, the throw, gets a good block from Grant and knocked out of the air. by DeWaylen Cook, the safety. Nice defensive play by the main green in that secondary.
That's where right there Star Jackson can work on his game. A little bit more air under that football to the corner of the end zone. You take a look at it right here. It's more on the line, and it allows the defender to make a play. Put that one a little more arc over it to the corner of the end zone. You're on the sideline celebrating with your teammates.
Is that a spot throw? Are you trying to throw to a spot?
Yeah, once you identify where the man coverage is, yes, because you want to lead him away from that defender and put a little air on it.
Tiffin's field goal is up and good. Lee with a couple of field goals today. He is now 8 out of 10 on the year. Alabama's lead is 40. Today, despite a lot of rain over the last 24 hours, these fans all about their Crimson Tide as they lead North Texas 47-7, 11:42 to go in the contest. Lee Tiffin will kick off once again. He's had some good kickoffs here, been pretty deep. This one, however, will fall to the 2-yard line, and Dunbar will bobble it and scramble his way out over the 10 to the 14-yard line. Let's go check in with our SEC Network studio host, Rob Stone. Rob.
Dave, the battle of the Commonwealth back and forth. Derek Locke had given Kentucky the lead, and then Justin Burke, and look at the catch by Trent Guy, 66 yards. Louisville reclaims the lead, 27-24.
Man, they got a shootout going. The Cardinals and the Cats. Here, not so back and forth. 47-7. Alabama out in front. Well, obviously a busy day around the conference, Andre, and there are some notable games that we're keeping an eye on. Obviously, starting in about 35, 40 minutes, Tennessee and Florida will go at it. I think we've talked about that one enough, but I like the bottom two games right there.
Yeah.
Georgia at Arkansas will tell us a lot, and West Virginia at Auburn.
Tough to go to Arkansas and win. They had a bye week last week. They were off an extra couple of days to get prepared for Georgia.
Darius Carey close to the first down. You know, Ryan Mallett had to redshirt or took a transfer year off, came from Michigan.
Can make every throw. It's amazing, and you match him with Bobby Petrino's offense, it's a match made in football heaven.
Look at some of the numbers on the Razorbacks, and you know they blew out Missouri State in week one 48-10, but now it's the real deal. Also keep an eye on Ole Miss. So they've had like almost half their team out with the flu in the past 10 days. That handoff goes to Micah Mosley, the fullback. He'll be close to that first down. I don't know if he got it, but Dexter McCluster, Jevin Steed, I mean, they couldn't even practice now. They had an off week last Saturday, which came at a good time. Now you look back and you say, yeah, it was a good time because of the flu. Ole Miss is going to have to start to play some good football. I think they were a little sluggish at Memphis in their opener. And I'll be interested to see how they play with all those guys that have been sick.
And that's a good point because Mark Ingram suffered from that flu and lost 12, 13 pounds.
Yeah.
Basically just getting himself rounded back into 100%. So it has been bad. Knock on wood, my man. I hope I don't experience it. It just passes right on by my doorstep.
Trent Richardson back to return this punt. And that will sail out of bounds. So no return. They will continue to mark it in favor of the Crimson Tide. They will stop it at the 40-yard line. Actually, they're still bringing them up. Make it the 44-yard line with 9:42 to go. There's a timeout on the field. We'll step aside. Nick Saban's club in control. You are looking at where the president of the University of Alabama, Dr. Robert E. Witt, sleeps every night here on campus. That is one of those four buildings that did not get burned down during the Civil War. Here's Dimitri. It's good with a big hole on his first carry this afternoon. Time to take a look at our Polaris ORV hardest working player of the game, and it's got to be Javier Arenas on his punt and kick returns. He was awesome today.
On that alone, I mean, you're here taking punishment, but talk about hardest working. Watch this run. Watch this return. Break one tackle. Break another. Spin. Carry a couple of guys. If he doesn't win it, I don't know who's more deserving right there. Hardest working player of the game for us today, Javier Arenas. Javier has been magnificent. Four punt returns, 90 yards, and a kickoff return as well for 61 yards.
That's 151 bonus yards you just got.
Positive yardage. He's been amazing.
He and Brandon James at Florida. I don't know that there's been two return men at the same time in this league that if their careers as return men have mirrored each other.
Yeah, and they know he's coming. Yeah. I mean, he's back there and he's still able to do it. Teams prepare for him, and he's still been fantastic.
Here's Grant off the left side. About a yard on the play. Javon Atkinson, one of those junior college transfers up front for North Texas, in on the tackle. Oh, we got a second. Let me ask you about Auburn. They bring in Gus Malzahn, offensive coordinator, runs that spread. You think throwing it all over the chucking all over the field. They got the two top rushers in the conference over there at Auburn right now. They're churning up 350 yards a game on the ground.
Just go back to what he did at Tulsa. Everybody thought, well, Tulsa's throwing it around. They're about as balanced as you could get in the country.
Jackson's pass is caught inside the 20. Brandon Gibson, the sophomore at Mobile.
Well, they're in good hands with Star Jackson. I mean, the future looks very, very bright for this young man, and constantly being challenged by Coach Saban. He was put into a two-minute situation, really not knowing that that would happen in this ball game. He was ready, stepped up, answered the challenge, and led the team down for a field goal. And it's pretty much had the entire second half here.
Here goes Terry Grant inside the 15, down to the 13. Time to get another update. Means we got to go to our SEC Network studios. Rob.
Dave, number 8, Cal at Minnesota, 2 unbeatens. Fourth quarter, Kevin Riley to Jeremy Ross for 31 yards. Down to the 1 yard line, 2 plays later. Who else? Javon.Best with a touchdown to give Cal the lead.
Boy, Cal trying to survive.
Go to your best player and Javon.Best, and he delivers for Cal.
Here's Terry Grant. The left side down to the 10 yard line. That'll bring up third down and short.
I was talking about Star Jackson, redshirt freshman quarterback. You have a name and you play quarterback. You had a name like Star, you better be able to play. And he's delivered, but love the name Star Jackson. Is there a better name for a quarterback? The only thing better is if he goes on and has a nice career here at Alabama and goes to Dallas as the quarterback of the Cowboys.
Terry Grant with 16 carries today. I think it's 17. He might be about a yard shy of the first down. The Wigway in on the tackle.
Terry Grant tackled by Toby and Wigway.
So fourth and a yard. Alabama will go for it. Baron Huber is the fullback. Grant the tailback. The offset eye. It's Grant to the 5. Touchdown, Alabama.
And a couple of youngsters up front. Alfred McCullough, the sophomore left tackle. David Ross in at center. Nice job up front, creating a nice little running lane for Terry Grant, who has had a nice ball game in his own right.
Difference point after, up and good. No good, excuse me. That's a second one he's missed today.
Oh boy.
He has been off the mark today. Gonna need those as the season progresses. Terry Grant, gonna need him too. He's looked pretty good here in the second half. at Bryant-Denny Stadium, where Alabama leads it 53-7, just under 6 minutes to go. North Texas out of the Sun Belt taking on SEC power Alabama. Dave Neal, Andre Ware, Kerry Capuano. Greg McElroy has had a quiet second half because he's put together a pretty good show in the first half. 13 out of 15, two touchdowns through the air, one on the ground. Alabama rushing 262 today. Total offense, 525.
Wow.
Ira Smith will field it. Excuse me, Hamilton will field it and be walloped at the 20-yard line. Time to get an update. Let's go to Rob Stone.
Louisville's Trent Guy fumbled a punt. Kentucky recovered. A few plays later, Mike Hartline looks right, lobs it left. Randall Cobb, a man all over him, pulls it in. Wildcats with the lead, under five to go.
That's a good football game.
I told you about Randall Cobb now. People in this league better get used to that name.
Good football game.
Tell you what, Kentucky, Commonwealth Stadium. I've been there enough over the years when they've been pretty good. That's a tough place to go win when they've got a little bit of mojo on their side. Hamilton with the carry. He's out to the 30-yard line. Get your tickets now to the fourth annual PapaJohns.com Bowl. The SEC Big East matchup will take place January 2nd at Legion Field in Birmingham, Alabama. Visit PapaJohnsBowl.com or call 205-413-4849 for more details. It's Southern Hospitality meets serious football. In just about 30 minutes, there'll be some serious football going on in Gainesville, Florida. Gators and the Volunteers get set to tangle. Here's Hamilton again, going back the other way. Got a few blockers. Gets one from Nathan Toon. That game today between Tennessee and Florida, of course, people wondering about that series. It's actually 19-19, but Florida's owned this series of late, including winning four straight. And, you know, it's time to put the mouthpiece in and play ball now. What do you think? You said it'll be close for a while.
For about a half. And then Florida's athletes will take over. I mean, there's a lot of young talent at Tennessee, a good mixture of upperclassmen and true freshmen. But Florida, speed kills.
You know, we've had a look at both those teams. And you know, Jonathan Crompton in week one looked awesome,
like he was going to have a breakout season. And then last week against UCLA, you know, he had a tough afternoon. And if he thought it was tough against the Bruins, when you go down and face Florida's defense with all 11 starters coming back, whoo, and then you've given him a little reason to get a little angry.
Yeah. Here's Hamilton. Run a little stretch play out to the 39-yard line. Of course, Tim Tebow on the other side has gotten off to a great start in his senior season. Look at the numbers in their careers. 77 touchdowns, and it's the 11 interceptions to me for Tim Tebow. That's amazing for a career.
All right, we're not talking about a couple of years. The entire time he's been at Florida, he's thrown only 11 interceptions. He is a perfectionist, though. We're away from drills. He's constantly working on his game, working to get better as a football player. And it's contagious, because if you're a teammate, you feel obligated to have to match that intensity.
Here's Hamilton to the 46-yard line. That should be good enough for a mean green first down.
Where was this running game early in the ball game for North Texas? We talked to coaches from Alabama. Kirby Smart, their defensive coordinator, very concerned about the running game of North Texas. They were very balanced coming into this game, but all but abandoned trying to run the football.
Jeremy Mathis in at running back. He's wearing number 24 for North Texas. Nathan Toon going the distance here for North Texas. by Chris Jordan, who stepped into the hole. Well, celebrating its fifth year sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets, Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kick. To date, Allstate has contributed more than $1.8 million in scholarship monies. About to hit the 2-minute mark. Left to go in this one. Mathis. Taken to the 47-yard line, 48-yard line. That'll bring up third down. So, Andre, after looking at this Alabama team and what you've seen, we've seen, you know, Florida predicted to win the East. Mm-hmm. This Western Division up in the air. Alabama, obviously a contender, ranked fourth in the country.
They could throw LSU in there. We'll get a chance to see them next week in Starkville at Mississippi State, but you definitely have to mention them as well as a favorite of the West. But a lot of talent on this Alabama football team.
Like what you see.
Like what I'm seeing.
Mathis. Nowhere to go. That'll bring up fourth down, under a minute to play. Nico Johnson with the tackle. Let's take a look now at our Good Hands play of the day, brought to you by Allstate. Go back to first half action. Marquise Mays from Greg McElroy right on the number. Touchdown Alabama.
Well, you were impressed with the way that they go man-to-man coverage. He attacked the safety Iris Smith and just killed the cushion, and right in stride Greg McElroy connects with Marquise Mays. And Marquise Mays, we talk about a lot of young talent, sophomore. He's going to be around another couple of seasons for Nick Saban. Greg McElroy, just a junior. So this team is only going to get better.
North Texas will take a timeout with 16 seconds to play. It's fourth and four is coming up. And we will take our last break as well. Back in a moment. Well, there's some dedicated Bama fans staying to the end of this one. 53-7, just 16 ticks of the clock left before Alabama picks up their third win of the year.
Fans are coachable, you know.
That's right. You learn, right?
As a player, you learn to play to the end of the clock. Play the last whistle.
Nico Johnson able to bring down Jeremy Mathis short of the first down. With 10 seconds to play, so Alabama's offense will come back out for one final snap.
My favorite formation, the old victory formation, where you just, if you're in it at the end of a game, you've won the football game.
You know, the old school ways of clock management, they would start it on the set.
Yeah.
A couple years ago, remember that?
Oh, yeah.
That was not a good year.
Games were flying. Coaches hated that. Hated that rule change.
Thomas Dara gets to come in and take a knee. That quarterback. And he'll do it now. Wrap it up for the Crimson Tide, who held North Texas to under 190 yards of offense. And the Crimson Tide put up over 500 of their own. Their third straight game with over 500 yards of offense. This team looks pretty complete. A couple of special teams miscues today. But overall, Andre, your thoughts about the Tide?
Well, a lot of young talent, a couple of mistakes early in the game, but they were a good football team, usually overcomes that, and they were able to do so. I thought Greg McElroy is a good, calm leader for this football team, but a lot of talent for Nick Saban.
Let's go check in with Kara.
Well, guys, Coach, you challenged the team to make a faster start this week. It seems like they answered that call. What will be the focal point heading into this game against Arkansas?
Well, I think, you know, we want to carry some momentum into the game. Arkansas has got a very, very good team.
So, you know, SEC play, everybody's got to ramp it up a notch. But I think we got a chance to play a lot of players today, which will help our depth down the road, and especially Star Jackson getting in as a quarterback. We ever need him down the road. So I was pleased and happy with the way our guys performed overall today.
I'm sure we'll see a lot more Greg McElroy next week. In your eyes, where can he continue to improve after a really great day?
Well, he's done a good job for us, but, you know, the pass rush is going to be better. The coverage is going to be a little bit better. So everything you do has got to be a little more refined. And I'm sure Greg will continue to improve and do the things he needs to do to be a better player.
You know this conference as well as everybody. So three very different opponents, games 1 through 3. What will Arkansas bring to town?
Well, you know, Arkansas's got a good team. Bobby's a great offensive coach, and they've improved defensively as the season went on last year. So, you know, they got a good team. They've got good football players. Anybody in the SEC can beat anybody, so we're going to have to play one of our best games.
Coach, congratulations. Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Today's SEC Network game has been brought to you by Polaris. See the hardest working, smoothest riding off-road vehicle now at your local dealer. Champion, it's how you play. Allstate, you're in good hands. The third annual SEC Big East Invitational, December 9th and 10th in both New York and Tampa. Cooper Tires, don't give up a thing. And by Nissan, shift the way you move.
All right, well, more interviews down on the field, and let's check in with Kara once again.
Well, guys, I'm with the starter, Greg McElroy. And, Greg, another unbelievably accurate performance for you. How do you do that?
Well, I think when they give us opportunities and the play calling is the way it's been the last couple weeks, it gives us easy completions. And those completions are there to be had, and it makes my life really easy with guys as open as they are. Just hitting them with the ball is the simplest part of the game.
Next week, you'll make your first start in a conference game. From your experiences in the SEC, what will be different for you?
It will be completely different. It'll be a different approach. It'll be different than any team we've played up to this point. Arkansas is known for a lot of man coverage and a great offense. Coach Petrino's doing great things up there. We're going to have a great week of work and come out prepared next Saturday.
Julio Jones hoping to be back for that tilt. Having him back, how will that change the game plan for you?
Well, we kind of changed the game plan slightly, but we're going to do what we do. I think we have a lot of confidence on offense right now. Just got to continue to play fundamental football, try to limit our turnovers and control the clock as much as possible. And we should have a good outcome next week, and we're looking forward to it.
You've certainly enjoyed spreading the wealth. Thanks, Greg. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much, Kara, as Alabama wins it big time. Time for us to check in once again with our SEC Network studios. Here's Rob Stone.